there everyone. In this lesson we're going to make this bag. It turned out really well. It's got a lining inside it, whichever color you want, and it's folded over so you don't see any of the lining when you just look in it. It's yeah, you can choose any color lining because it'll bring out that color pretty well. It's not very hard, but yeah, it's got two little doilies and then a side piece which makes up the bag. Yeah, that side piece over there. So it works, it really crochets very quickly. So if you're looking for a quick project, this certainly is a quick project. But yeah, that's the bag and I'm going to show you how to make it. So let's get started. Begin our bag. You're going to need a size 6mm crochet hook, which is a J. Alright, so get yourself one of those, and I'm using peaches and cream cotton. This is a medium 4, and I used the peaches and cream, or it comes in a different make, but as long as it's a size 4 medium, it doesn't really matter your size too much. But yeah, you're going to need that. Then you're going to need some fabric to line your bag with. Any fabric, if you want to go lacy or if you want to go with a thicker fabric, you can do that as well. And you can use a thicker fabric too. I've used a black color. You can use any color. And mine's fairly thick. It's a fairly thick one. And I've crocheted this all around mine. And I've made the inside like that. And I'll show you what to do. Yeah, it's very simple. There's no pattern. You just cut it out, and your fabric for the inside, you just cut it out. It's just kind of made free form, and then the rest of the bag we'll crochet together. But yeah, so I'll show you how to do that. So pattern looks like from close, and it's fairly large. Let's see the. I didn't measure the size. It measures from the one side. Let's take from one of these peaks across to another peak is, just on 17 inches. So it's pretty large. It's not too bad. 16 and a half to 17 inches depends on how much you stretch it out. Yeah, I'd say 16 and a half inches wide, which is a nice size. If you want your smaller, you'll have to use a thinner crochet hook and thread, which will also work. So, anyway, so to begin our work, you're going to chain 8 stitches. So, let me get a slip knot on, and you're going to chain 8, and then you're going to slip stitch into your first stitch. So, I'm going to go ahead and do mine. 1, 2, 7, 8, and then you're going to slip stitch into the beginning, and then you're going to chain 1, and that's going to stand for your first single crochet, and you're going to do 11 more in here because you want 12 all together. So don't make this one too tight. That's number 1, and then you're going to just do another 11 single crochets in your circle. So you can go ahead and do that, and then I will meet you back once you have all of your stitches. All right, so once you've got your 12, you can also go ahead and count them this way. You can see there's your stitch. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So make sure you have 12. Then you're going to just slip stitch into that first stitch. Get rid of that. Just slip stitch into that stitch. Okay, now you're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3. And this stands for your first double crochet. Now we're going to make a picot. So you're going to chain another 3. So just hold it there and 1, 2, 3, and then for our picot, you're going to go into that third chain. So you have 1, 2, 3, and then there will picot over here. Do a single crochet in there. Okay, and then you're going to do a double crochet. Sorry, then you're going to chain 1, and then you're going to do a double crochet in this next stitch over here. Whoops. So that's your double. Let's just get it right under there. Okay, so you did chain 3, you made a picot by making another chain 3 and going into the first chain with a single, chain 1, 1 double in your next stitch. Now we're going to make another picot. So 1, to 3 chain, and I go into these two. I go into these two stitches here, or if you don't want that, go into your third chain, your first chain out of the 3. Whoops. But I just go into those two. I prefer going into these two stitches. Single crochet, and then you're going to chain 1, and then you're going to do a double in your next stitch. Okay, another picot. 1, 2, 3. Single in there. Chain 1, and a double in the next stitch. And this is what you're going to do all the way around. Picot, 1, 2, 3, single in that first chain, chain 1, and a double in your next stitch. And you need to go around and do that, and once you've done that, I will come back here and I'll meet you at the beginning. So just keep doing that. You're going in each one of these stitches, and I'll meet you back now. So once you've come around, you're going to be sure to have 12 of these double crochets. Okay, you must have 12 of these to form our pattern. So this is my 12th one, and I've made my picot. Now, instead of making a chain, you would have done a chain there. You're going to just go into this top stitch and you're going to do a single crochet. And that's how you end that round over there. Now, for our next round, you're going to chain 8. 1, 2, 3, 7, 8. Now, you're doing the 8 chain because the first 4 stand for a treble, and then the next 4 are 4 chain in between. Alright, so this is a pretty easy round. Now you're going to do a treble. So wrap your yarn around twice. Now, I'm coming into the back of this stitch in between the 2 picots. So I'm just going to find the back, and I'm coming into the back over here. Okay, those back 2 there. And I'm going to do my treble. So you're going to be like this. This is standing for our treble. Okay, and then you're going to chain 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're going to wrap your yarn around twice, and you're going to go into the back. Here your picots are. So you're going into the back of the stitch in between those two. You had made a chain there. Might be easy just to come from this way, go backwards into this one, and then come around. It's not the end of the world if you don't want to go through the back. You can just come into the stitch through the front, but it just puts this a little bit more forward and that back. That's why I'm doing it. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and same thing. You're going to do that all the way around. Just come into the back of this stitch, just like that. Okay, and then you do your chain 4, and you should be looking like this. Okay, so you can go ahead and do that. Go all the way around, and I'll meet you back here. So when you've come around, you're going to end off with your chain 4. Now, once again, you should still have 12 of these double crochets going all the way. Now, you're going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're going to just do a slip stitch into that 4th chain. So you should be looking like this. See, it just pushes these up a bit by going into the back, but it doesn't, it's not the end of the world. Okay, if you then you've slip stitched into that 4th chain there. Now I'm just going to do a slip stitch into the next chain just to bring myself a little closer there. Then I'm going to chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and then you're going to do a double crochet in the next chain. You're going to do it in the next 2. I'm just going into this next one over here with a double, and double into the next one. It's a little tricky, but you just have to go into them there. Okay, so you should have 3 double crochets, and you're going to chain 3, and you're going to do 3 doubles in here as well. So just go into 3, 1, 2, 3, and leave the end, or do 2 in here and 1 in there. Let's just do it. So we'll have 1 each open there. So I'm going to do 2 in here. You just want 3 double crochets. So 1, 2, and 3. So however you want to put them in your chains. However you want to have them in your chains, That's if you do it like that. That's if you do them closer together. So it doesn't really matter. And then chain three. One, two, three. Okay, so I'm going to get, I'll put two in here. One, two in the one, and one in the next. You just kind of want, you're really just wanting them to be evenly spread out on that chain. You know, as you can see here, it doesn't really matter. I did them like that. It's not that noticeable. It's not one of those critical things. And then you do chain three. So you can go ahead and do that. As I say, you're just wanting three doubles in here. It's better not to put it in the chain space. I mean, you can, but it is a little bit better for it to actually be in the chain because it keeps it more stable there. But that's your call once again. So three double crochets, chain three, three doubles, chain three all the way, and I'll meet you back here. So now that you've come all the way around, do your chain three, and you're going to slip stitch into the top of this chain three over here. Slip stitch in there, and you're going to chain three. This chain three stands for your first double crochet. You're going to do two doubles in here. One, two, and then you're going to do one more in the last one. So that gives you four double crochets. Okay, so you should be having four doubles. And then you're going to do chain three. One, two, three. And then the same thing in here. One in this first double. One in there. Two in the middle. One, two. And whoops. Two. And one in this last double. So you have four over the three. One there, two in the middle, and one over there. Okay, and then chain three. So you can go ahead and do this round. One in here, two in there, one in there, and chain three. And that's starting to build your double crochets over here. So you can go ahead and do that, and I will meet you back at the end of this round. So chain three, come into the top of this stitch again, slip stitch through that, then you're going to chain three, one, two, three, and then you're going to put two doubles in this first one. So one, two, and then one each in each of the next one, two. So now you want five doubles. Your very first round, they had three, the next had four, and now it's five. So you got three, four, and five. And this is also going to be chain three. One, two, three. And then for this one, one double in the first, two in the next. That gives me three. And then one each. That's four and five. And then you'll chain three. One, two, three. So one in there, two in there, one and one. It gives me five with a chain three. And you can see that your bag is starting to get a little bit bigger. And this is starting to grow over here. So chain three, one in the first, two in there, one in there, one in there, chain three. So do that. And now this is the same thing, your three, and you're going to slip stitch into the top of this one. Now for this, it's an easy one. You're just doing one in each, so you want to keep your five and you're doing chain four. So one, two, three, that stands for my first one. So one, two, three, four, oops, four and five. So it's one double in each of the doubles with chain four in between. One, two, three, four. Okay, so one in here, one in there, 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 and chain four. So it's a nice easy round. One, two, three, four, and five, and then you chain four again. So you can go ahead and do that. chain four and one in each of these, so you have five doubles going around. So go ahead and do that and I'll meet you back at the beginning. Alright, so you've done your chain four, you're going to do the same thing, slip stitch into the top of this stitch and chain three. One, two, three. And we are starting to decrease now, so we're going to be doing stitches together. Now go into the next one with a double, into the next one with a double. So you have three there, and then you're going to do these last two together. So yarn over, go in there, go through two, leave the rest on your hook. Yarn over, go in there, go through two, and then you go through all of these, and you've got two together. Chain seven, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now for the next one and all the rest, you're going to do these two together, do one in those two together. Okay, so go into your first stitch, go through two, leave those on, yarn over, go into the next stitch, go through two, and then go through all three. Now I've done these two together, one in the next, and then the last two together. So this one and this one. Go through all three and then chain seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And then the same thing. This one, yarn over the next one, go through all three, one regular double in there, and the next two together. That one and that one, and then chain seven. So this isn't too hard, you're just doing your chain seven and then the first two together, one regular double and the next two together. So you should end up with one, two, three stitches for this round, and then you got chain seven in between. So you can go ahead and do that and I'll meet you once you've done that round. So you slip stitch into the top of this stitch again, and this next round is a little bit trickier because we almost finished with this little pattern over there. So you're going to chain three and then these last two are going to get done together. So you're going to do one there and one here. Do these two together and then through all of them. Then you're going to do chain three and this is going to become a picot. So you've done, these three are being done together. Chain three and then you do your picot over here. And then you're going to chain four. One, two, three, four. Then in the middle three, one, two, three stitches, you're going to be doing single crochets and picots. So you're going to go into the first one. So you're skipping these two and it's the middle three. So this will be my first one over here. It's not an exact science once again. Just do it as best as you can. It's a single crochet. Then you're going to picot. One, two, three. And I go into these two with a single. And then you're going to do another single in the next one. Single crochet in the next and then picot again. Whoops. One, two, three with the picot. And then a single in the next. And another picot. So you want three of those. Okay, so you look like that. You've got your three over there. Okay, then you're going to do your four chain. One, two, three, four chain. And then these ones, you're going to be doing them together. So one, two, three. These three are done together. A double in here. Don't finish it. A double in here. Don't finish it. And a double in here. And then you can finish, go through all of them. Now you want a picot on top of this. So one, two, three, and however you do it, let me just see something. So picot there, and I just go through those two again. Okay, and then it's chain four. So this is what we're going to be repeating. And you just got a little bit of a pattern like that. So what you're repeating is chain four. One, two, three, four. Well, it's actually the picot and then chain four. But you do chain four there. Then these middle three, you're going to do a single crochet. Picot, one, two, three. And then a single in the next chain with a picot, one, two, three, and then a single in the next one. So you're just going into the next chain with a picot, one, two, three, and then you've got to do your chain four again, one, two, three, four. Okay. So now, I'll just do it with you. You're going to go do these three together. One, two, three. Those three together with a picot on top of that. Chain four. Single picot, single picot, single picot. Chain four and these three together. And that's the pattern. So I'll do it with you one more time. Did I chain four. Four? Doubles together. One, two, and three. Do those together, and then you do your picot above that. So one, two, three. That one you don't want to forget about. That one, it's a bit of an easy one to forget. Easy to forget, but that's your picot, and then chain four. One, two, three, four, and then you're going to go into these ones with a single picot and a single in the next. The picot. And a single in the next. So you have three of those with a picot and chain four. One, two, three, four, and then we do our doubles again. Okay, so what you have is your chain, you do your doubles together with a picot, chain four, single picot, single picot, single picot, chain four, doubles together, and a picot above those. Your chain four, your doubles with your picots, chain four, doubles together, and a picot above that. So go ahead and do that, and I'll meet you back here. Okay, so to end this one, you're going to do chain two. And then you're going to do a double crochet into this top stitch over here. You do a double into there. Okay. Now so you're going to chain five stitches. So it's one, two, three, four, five. And you're going to do a single crochet in this first chain space. You'll do a single there. And then you're going to do chain nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and a single in the next chain space, which is here over these. And then it's going to be chain five. One, two, three, four, five, and a single in the next chain space. So a chain five goes over this one here, and chain nine goes over these. And you're just working from single, from space to space, chain space. So now I've got the big one, so it's chain nine. So now it's chain nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And then you're going to do a single in here. And then it's chain five. Whoops. And then it's chain five and a single in there. Chain nine, single in there. So do that all the way around and I'll meet you back. All right, so to finish this one, you're going to do chain five and you're going to do a treble. You can see there the stitches you're going over. This is where we did the double in the previous round. And that's what you're going to be going into. So chain five, Wrap your yarn around twice and go into that double that you had made with your treble. Go through two. So when you do that, it brings you into the middle of your stitch. Okay, now you're going to do chain four. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so you do your chain four. Then this is where the treble that you just made into your double. Okay, you're going to do a double crochet over that chain one, and then double crochet, chain one, and a double crochet, and chain one. Sorry, chain three will be the next step, and then you're going to chain three. So this is that, this is the treble that you'd made. You had to chain five, and then you did a treble into this double crochet, and that brought you there. And then that's the double that you'd made, just doing these stitches over that. Okay, and then you're going to do chain three, and then in this one you're going to do a single crochet, chain three, 1, 2, 3. Now in this stitches, these in this chain space, you're going to do a double chain one. You're doing four of these, a double with chain one, four times. 1, 2, and this is the chain space over there. 3, chain, and 4. Okay, so it's four doubles with a chain in between them. Then you're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and then the same thing in the same space over here. 1, chain, double, with a chain and a double. So we should end up with four of these with a chain. And I'll go through this again with you. Okay, so that's the treble that you had made. Okay, that's it. You ended off with chain five and a treble, and you ended up here. Then you did your chain four, and then this was the treble. You went into that space, double crochet, chain, double, chain, double, chain three. Then your next chain space, you did a single, chain three. Then you do your double, chain, double, chain, double, chain, double, chain three, and that's in this bigger one. Same thing, double, chain, double, four of those. Now you've got your smaller, because you can see you got, you had your chain five, your chain nine. And it's in your chain nine that you're doing this little pattern there. Okay, so now in this one, it was chain three, 1, 2, 3, with a single crochet in there, and then chain three again, 1, 2, 3. And then this is the one that had the four doubles, chain three, four doubles with one in between. Okay, so now it's a double, chain one, double, chain one, double, chain one, and a double. And then it's chain three, 1, 2, 3, and then the same thing in the same space. A double, chain one. Sorry, my yarn keeps getting caught. Chain one, a double. This is the second one. Chain one, a double, chain one, and a double. And now we have our chain threes. Okay, so now we've got the smaller chain, and this was 1, 2, 3, with a single in that one, and then 1, 2, 3. Okay, and now it's the four chains with three in between. Double crochet, double, chain one, double, chain one, that's two. This is a third one, this is the fourth one, and then you have your chain three, 1, 2, 3, and then the same thing in the same thing in the same space. Double, chain one, number two, chain one, number three, chain one, and number four. Okay, and now once again, it's chain three, single, chain three, double, chain one, double, chain one, that's four times, chain three, and then the same thing here, four doubles with one in between, chain three, single, chain three, and your four doubles. So you can go ahead and do that, and I will meet you back at the beginning. Alright, so when you come to the beginning here, you're only going to be doing four in this last one, chain three, and then you're going to slip stitch into the top of this chain here. So be careful not to make a set of eight plus this one. You're just doing half for one in the end here. All right, now for our very last round, we're just going to be doing single crochet. So I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to do a single crochet in each one of these and three in all the chain spaces. So we'll do one in here, and then whenever you have a chain space, you'll do three. One, two, three. It's just to firm this end part up. So there's another three. One, two, three. And then just go into each of these spaces. One, two, three. And then here again, three. One. That's how simple this is going to be. And then that's going to be it. Well, for this part. One, two, three. And then one in here. One in here, one in here, whoops, and three in here, one, 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 three in there. So wherever you've got a big chain space, you're going to do three. All the others just get one. So you can go ahead, do that, and when you finish, just come and slip stitch into your very first chain that you had made. And then that is your body part of your bag complete. So go ahead and do that, and then I'll show you how to do the rest. Once you've completed your motif, you are going to want to get your fabric. I think a yard of fabric should work all right. Double it up so that you've got two sides, so you can cut two of these out. Then you're going to put this on, and you're going to stretch it out more or less, not overstretched, but just so it's pretty equal on either side. Now I'm going to use my rotary cutter, and you want to cut about an inch. I'd rather have too much fabric than too little, because we're going to sew on it. So around about an inch around it, you can just cut all the way around evenly. If you want to draw a line and be very specific with an inch, you can. I'm not. I'm just really going more or less an inch around all of it, an inch from this top part, and just cut it out like this, and then I will meet you back again. So cut it out so it's basically an inch around, and I'll meet you back now. All right, once you've cut out your round piece of fabric, you should end up with two of these. You're going to take your leftover piece, and you want a long straight piece. Now I'm going to make mine about 40, mine's going to be about 42 inches long. So you want to cut out a very long piece. You're going to cut two of those out, so you can double your fabric, and make it about 3 inches wide, because we need some for our seam allowance. I wanted to be about two, and then we'll have a bit of a seam allowance on either side. So make that 3 inches wide. You want two of these strips, and about 40 to 45 in length, because that's also going to work for our shoulder. And then I'll show you. All right, so now I told you to cut it out like an inch around your actual crocheting. Now I want to make mine smaller. I prefer doing it this way so that I can get it a little bit more accurate as I go now, as I cut it out now. But it's up to you. If you don't have enough fabric, you can go ahead and cut it, you know, equal to more or less this one. It's not a perfect art here. You just want to cut it so that it's round, you know, that you have the circles. I just prefer doing it this way, but it doesn't really matter which way you do it. But you just want to cut it so it's, you just want to cut it so you're really going around in a circle, and you're just following that top piece there. This isn't a perfect science, and it doesn't matter if it's not the right size, but you just generally want to have it in a round circle. So it's this the size of your motif that you made. I just find this easier, but as I say, if you don't want to cut it out larger first, you can just cut it this size first time around. I just find it a little bit easier to get a bit more of a precise circle. So cut yours out, and then I'm going to sew mine. It's not that much more that you're cutting off anyway, but you know, sometimes you might just have a little bit of fabric, and this might have taken it just over the edge. This was just a piece I didn't need anymore. Okay, now I've got it pretty well. All right, so the next thing that you want to do is you're going to take your band that you made, and mine is 44 inches, and you're going to take the circle that you have, one of your circles, and you're going to take the circle, and we're going to be pinning the band onto our circle. So you take your circled part, you can start anywhere, and just put it on, pin it on. Just take your pin and pin it on all the way around. And it's not going to be perfect because you've got a circle with a straight line, but just pin it on as best you can. Now, if you don't want to sew, you can use glue. As far as I know, you can use the fabric glue. I don't have any fabric glue, so I'm preferring to do it like this. But just go all the way around. Pin it like that so it looks like this. Keep the two together. I'm keeping mine together. So I started on the one side and I just pinned it on like that all the way around, and it's come up to this side. So you should have a little bit of a gap left over here. All right, then what you're going to do is you're going to go and sew this piece on. Sew it on or glue it on, whatever you're doing. You can hand sew it as well. This is just the inside liner, so you don't have to be too perfect in what you're doing. So go ahead and sew that on, and then I'll meet you back here. All right, so as you can see, I've sewn mine on. I left that part open there. I left so much open. This one's actually a little less, but I'm going to come back to that. Just leave 3 inches. That one's 3. This one, yeah, that one should have gone up a bit more, but I'm going to come back. This is on the inside of your bag, so it doesn't matter. Now, once you've done that, it should be looking like this. So you just sew this all the way around onto that, the band that you made. Okay, now you're going to take the other piece and make sure that it's fitting on this one the way, so these two match. Okay. Whatever then. As I say, this isn't an exact science. This is just a quick lining for inside. Okay, now I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to take this one and I'm going to sew it over there. Okay, I'm going to start this one over here and I'm going to go all the way around, and don't worry, we'll come back to this. Just sew this one the same side as this one. So I'm going to come and sew it on here now, and you're going to come all the way around, and then you've got a bit of a bag here. So do that and I'll meet you back. All right, so now what you're going to do once this is together, you can make these equal. Just this one of mine needs to be sewn up a little bit more. Just make sure they're equal. Mine's about 3 centimeters, as I said. Just make sure you've got them equal once you're done. So let's just pretend mine is. I just need to go in there and sew it a little bit more. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to be folding this part where your sewing is. You want to fold that over. Okay, so this is your bag here. Whoops. You're going to fold this part over here because we need an opening. See, here's your bag. So you just take this part and fold it over where your sewing is. They should be more or less together. Then you're going to take this little piece of your flap and you're going to flip it over onto the side. Now, I haven't overlocked any of my fabric. This fabric doesn't seem to fray a lot. If yours frays a lot, you might need to overlock your work. But as I say, this is just a it's not a fancy inside for the bag. It's really just to hold your things, as long as it's secure. But if yours is fraying badly, you might need to get some, if you're not sewing, get some glue that glues it together. And if you're gluing your whole thing, just make sure that you have that so it doesn't fray. Whichever method you're using, as I say, if you're using glue, then it's also fine. I think you get a fraying spray or some kind of a glue. Anyway, so this is going to be flipped over and you're going to sew it together. So you're going to just flip it over and you're going to sew it over here. Just sew this part here. So you join it with that sewing. So you don't really have to sew that part up there. As long as you have it equal there, you can sew it together here. So this is going to be sewn together. Just makes it easier if it is, because you must be sure to be on the same spot as this one. And then you're going to just sew this onto here. Okay. So that part and this part. So you're just sewing this onto there. So this is the same size as this. You've just flipped this over. Okay, so you do that to both sides. You flip them over like that. Then you're going to take this, and as I say, I'm just sewing mine. I'm just going to sew it. If you want to fold yours in, I might just fold this part of mine in like that. Just make sure you where this stitch is, and then just sew right across it. Just sew it so it's down, whether you sew it over here or the however, just make sure that you've got it so it's down. And you're going to do it on this side as well. Okay, so you should look like that. Those two are down, and you put this over and sewn this onto the seam here. So you're just carrying on with the seam like that. Okay, so once you've got that, you're going to take your strap and you're going to halve it. Now, once again, this is up to you. If you want to cut this in half so it's not as bulky or thick as this, you can, or you can just fold it over. But that's the size of it. That's the width of the strap that I'm going to be using. And you can either make it thicker like this. It's, if you make it thicker, it's going to hold stronger. And if you do, you can actually just sew it down here. Just sew it so it's not going anywhere. Sew it all the way over. But that's also up to you. You don't have to sew it. But we're going to put it onto here. Now you're going to put it onto, all of this is on the wrong side of your bag. And then you're going to just sew it across. Try and get it in the middle as best you can. And you're just going to sew this on here. Like that. And that's all the sewing or gluing that you will need to be doing. So it should be looking like this. Okay, and that's all going to be on the inside of your bag. Now, it's up to you. If you want to make this all fancy and looking nicer, or you want to get another strip of fabric and put it over this so you don't see all the sewing, that's fine, because you can put your other piece, say you've got another piece of fabric. You could just sew it on like that, flip it over and sew it on to that side like that, and then you won't see it. But I'm not trying to be fancy. This is just for the inside of the bag. And this is very secure. It's not going anywhere. And the type of fabric I have, it's not fraying. So, yeah, that's really all that you're needing to do. Sew this part. You fold it over. Fold this over. Sew that over there. You're not sewing this one across because you don't need to. You're just sewing it onto here and here. This one you're going to sew across onto here. And you can sew it on there. I would sew this one here, here, and here. So when you're wearing it, the pulling of it's not going to loosen your stitches. So this one is where you want it to be pretty strong. And then you have the inside of your bag. So you can go ahead and do that. Be sure that you've got all that sewing done. And then you can go ahead and make your bag. Yeah, so you can go ahead and do that. And then I'll show you how we're going to do the last one. All right, so I have mine finished. I just wanted to show you. I did sew mine together. And then I turned it inside out. So you just sew it together on the side. It takes a long time to pull it through, but then you just pull it through. And then I just sewed mine on like a little square. Need to get rid of all that. I just sewed it onto here like that. And then you've got this doubled and that doubled. And then I sewed across just like that. Okay, I sewed it across like that. So nothing is going anywhere. Now, when you put this on, be sure that you put that on. Hold it all the way so you're not twisting your band. Make sure that it's the right way when you put it on to the other side. And then your inside is done. Now we're going to put our crocheting on top.